today, which has 11 verses, ascribe to the Lord glory. Ascribe to the Lord all heavenly beings. Ascribe to the Lord glory and strength. Ascribe to the Lord the glory due to his name. Worship the Lord in the splendor of holiness. The voice of the Lord is over the waters. The Lord of glory thunders. The Lord over many waters. The voice of the Lord is powerful. The voice of the Lord is full of majesty. The voice of the Lord breaks the cedars. The Lord breaks the cedars of Lebanon. He makes Lebanon to skip like a calf, and Syrian like a young wild ox. The voice of the Lord flashes all the flames of fire. The voice of the Lord shakes the wilderness. The Lord shakes the wilderness of Kadesh. The voice of the Lord makes the deer give birth and strips the forests bare. And in his temper, all cry, glory. The Lord sits enthroned over the flood. The Lord sits enthroned as king forever. May the Lord give strength to his people. May the Lord bless his people with peace. This psalm is a hymn of praise to God for his awesome power. A diamond stone serves as a visible representation of God's majestic voice. It seems reasonable to suppose that setting the psalm in a thunderstorm deliberately places Yahweh over Baal, the storm god widely worshipped in Syria, Palestine. And so God created the phenomena of nature, and they serve his purposes and demonstrate his wisdom, glory, faithfulness, and even his love. My brothers and sisters, the psalm begins by urging the heavenly beings or angels to ascribe to the Lord glory and strength. That is to acknowledge that these things are true of God and that he deserves admiration of them. And so we are confident, for we have no other and we don't deserve another. We are okay with the Lord. The thunderstorm represents of the voice of the Lord. And the reader should imagine a magnificent storm coming eastward from the Mediterranean and sweeping through Israel, from the northern end, that is Sirion, to the southern end, that is Kadesh. And so the faithful worshipping in temple in Jerusalem see the storm source of power. They know that the voice of the Lord is even more powerful and even more full of majesty, and hence their responsive cry, glory. Remember these gentlemen, these men, when they were on their journey leaving Egypt in the wilderness, they all saw the glory of God even at the mount or the foot mountain Sinai. And so today, as we celebrate, as we turn ourselves to God, we need to, you know, to go before him with the utmost holiness and purity. And so to do what we're to do, to amen.
Baba tuna songea, Baba tuna songea, chini ya miguu yako, Baba tuna songea, Baba tuna songea, Baba tuna songea, ya miguu yako, Baba tuna songea.
talk about the